गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ए न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज 10th चैप्टर मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सॉलिड्स. We know substances are three types. First one is solids, second one is liquids, third one is gases. So here liquids, gases can flow, so these are known as fluids. So in this chapter we are discuss mechanical properties of a solid. Here rigid body is a hard solid object. Having a definite shape and size. Here, if we apply force on a body, the distance between two particles is not changed. So this type of body is known as a rigid body. If a object regained its original size and shape, when applied force is removed, that type of objects are called as elastic objects and this property is known as elasticity. If object does not regain original size and shape, that property is called plasticity. Such type of objects called plastics. So here example duff and clay. Here clay, when applied force is removed, it does not regain its original size and shape. Next one is elastic behavior of solids. We know that in a solid, each atom or molecule is surrounded by neighboring atoms or molecules. These are bounded together by interatomic or intermolecular forces. And stay in equilibrium position. When a solid is deformed, the atom or molecule are displaced from their equilibrium position. When deforming force is removed due to interatomic forces, the atoms tend to back their original position. Thus, the body regained original shape and size. Here, elastic behavior of solid can be explained by spring ball system. Here, balls represent atoms. Springs represent interatomic forces. Here, balls are connected with springs. If we try to displace any ball from its equilibrium position, the spring system tries to restore the ball back to its original position. Thus, elastic behavior of solid can be explained in terms of microscopic nature of solids. Next topic is stress. When a body is subjected to a deforming force, so that is applied force, a restoring force is developed in the body. So that restoring force is equal in magnitude and opposite direction to the applied force. So here stress is the restoring force for unit area is known as stress. If applied force is capital F and cross section area is capital A, then stress is, the magnitude of stress is F by A. Units is Newton per meter square or Pascals. Dimension formula. M L to 4 of minus 1, T to 4 of minus 2. A cylinder is stretched by two equal forces. applied normal to its cross sectional area. The restoring force per unit area is called tensile stress. So here I am taking a cylinder. So the length of the cylinder is L. Here it is length, this is cross sectional area. So here the cylinder is stretched by two equal forces. So one is this side and another one is this side. So the cylinder is stretched by two equal forces applied normal to its cross sectional area. The restoring force per unit area is known as tensile stress. If the cylinder is compressed under the action of applied force, the restoring force per unit area is known as compressive stress. Here, if the cylinder is compressed, here length of the cylinder is L, so here it is cross sectional area. So here I am applying two equal and opposite forces on cross sectional area. So here the length of the cylinder is decreased. So that is L minus del L. So here the force per unit area is known as compressive stress. Tensile stress or compressive stress can also be termed as a longitudinal stress. The change in length del L to the original length of the body is known as longitudinal strain. So your longitudinal strain is equal, therefore so here the ratio of change in del L to original length. The restoring force per unit area developed due to the applied tangential force is known as tangential or shearing stress. Here I am taking a cylinder length of L. So here I am applied tangential force along cross sectional area. Due to this tangential force, the restoring force per unit area is known as tangential or shearing stress. So here the relative displacement of two faces is del x. The length of the cylinder is L. So here angle is theta. So here how we can define shearing strain? The ratio of relative displacement of faces to the length of the cylinder is known as shearing strain. So here shearing strain is del x by L. So here it is theta. Here tan theta is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. So that is del x by L. So we can write del x by L is equal to tan theta. So if theta is small, so we can write sin theta is nearly equal to theta. So and tan theta is nearly equal to theta. So here shearing strain is equal, how we can write? So that is equal del x by L, that is called theta. A solid body placed in the fluid under high pressure. It compresses uniformly all sides. The force applied by the fluid act in the perpendicular direction at each point of the surface. So the body said to be under hydraulic compression. The volume is decreases without change its shape. The body develop internal restoring forces that are equal and opposite to the forces applied by the fluid. The internal restoring force per unit area is known as hydraulic stress. So the ratio of change in volume to original volume is known as volume strain. So here volume strain is del V by V. Next topic is Hooke's law. For small deformation, the stress and strain are proportional to each other. This is known as Hooke's law. So here stress is proportional to strain. If we remove proportionality, here we have to take a constant. So that is K strain. Here K is known as modulus of elasticity. See first problem. A copper wire of 1 millimeter diameter is stretched by applying a force of 10 Newton. Find the stress in the wire. In this problem, diameter of the copper wire is given. So that is D is equal to 1 millimeter. So that is converting meter. 1 milli is 10 to the power minus 3 meter. So what is the radius? So your radius is half of the diameter. So that is 1 by 2 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. And force is given, so that is 10 Newton. So here it is a copper wire. So this is a cross sectional area. So here A is equal pi r square. So here applying force is F, 10 Newton force is applied. So here we have to find stress. So here stress is equal force per unit area. So F by A. So F is given. So here A is pi r square. Here stress is equal force. Force is equal 10 Newton by area. Area is equal pi r square. So pi is 22 by 7 into r. R is 1 by 2 into 10 to the power of minus 3 whole square. So that is equal 10 into, take this 7 to numerator, so that is 7. So here it is 2 square, 1 by 2 square, 1 by 4, take numerator, that is 4, by remaining term 22 into 10 to the power of minus 3, 2 is a minus 6. So here 7 4 is a 28 by 7 4 is the 28 by 22 into 10 to 4 of, here it is minus 6, take numerator, it is plus 6 plus 1, that is 7. So finally we can get stress is equal, so here it is 1.273 into 10 to 4 of 7 Newton per meter square. See the second one. A tungsten wire of length 20 cm is stretched by 0.1 cm. Find the strain on the wire. So here length of the wire is given. Original length is given and change in length is given. So here we have to find strain. Strain is equal to change in length by original length. Here length of the tungsten wire is given. So that is 20 cm and the change in length is given. So that is 0.1 cm. So here we have to find strain. Strain is equal to change in length by original length. So that is, here strain is equal to, here del L is 0.1 by L is 20. So that is equal to, how we can write? So here it is 20 is, here 20 is 2 into 10. So here I am writing 1 by 2 into, here 1 by 10. So that is 0.01. Here 1 by 2 is equal 0.5 into 0.01. So therefore strain is how much? 0.005. See the third problem. If an iron wire is stretched by 1%, what is the strain on the wire? In this problem, iron wire stretched by 1%. So that is del L by L into 100 is equal to 1. So from this del L by L is equal to, how we can write? 1 by 100. So that is 0.01. Here we have to find strain. So that is change in length by original length. So here strain is how much? So here strain is how much? That is 0.01.